Good morning, everyone. Christina Simmons from Say Yes to Holiness here. So glad that you're able to join me today. Today is day 18 that we are on our Marian consecration. We are quickly growing ever closer to our consecration day, which is on the 31st of this month. So I'm super excited that you're here. And going ahead and get everybody live on, there we go, we're live, and then bring everybody into the room. Make sure I can see everybody on Facebook. There we go. Good morning. All right. There we go. Okay. Excellent. Yay. All right. We're live on Facebook. We're live here in Zoom. Welcome, everyone. Good morning. We're on day 18 of our consecration journey. And as we begin each of our days, let us begin with the prayer to the Holy Spirit, particularly appropriate as we are preparing and awaiting the Holy Spirit next Sunday on the 23rd for Pentecost. Good morning, Teresa, as well. So in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, amen. Come, Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of thy faithful and enkindle in them the fire of thy love. Send forth thy Spirit, and they shall be created, and thou shalt renew the face of the earth. O God, who didst teach the hearts of thy faithful people by sending them the light of thy Holy Spirit, grant us by the same Spirit to have right judgment in all things and evermore to rejoice in his holy comfort. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. O Holy Spirit, sweet guest of my soul, abide in me and grant that I may ever abide in thee. Amen. So today we begin with our reflection is a short quote from St. Louis de Montfort, who gave us the full 33-day preparation in different form. But he writes, when Mary has struck her roots in a soul, she produces the marvels of grace. Our reflection continues. It is important for a young plant to send down deep roots. Winds and harsh weather may beat against the tender plant, and if the roots are shallow, they will be uprooted and die. Yet if the roots are watered deeply on a regular basis, they will go very deep. In a similar way, when the roots of virtue and faith are watered by prayer and grace each day, the roots go deeper in a soul. Later, when suffering and temptation come, the plant is deeply rooted and weathers the storms. When a soul consecrates itself to our Blessed Mother, it invites Our Lady to establish her roots in the soul and to encourage the roots of faith and virtue to deepen and flourish. So our goal today, we wish to have Mary set deep roots in our souls. So there's a couple of things here that struck me as I was reading today. And one, of course, is tied to our goal that Mary set deep roots in our souls. But it's the same thing of where when we think about Mary is always bringing her closer to Jesus. And in the same way, Jesus talked about the seed and the sower, didn't he? He gave us several parables and he talked about the seed, how it falls on rocky ground and how it will fall on the path and be trampled in the among the thorns and, get choked, and then it'll fall on deep, rich soil. What Mary does is that she ensures that our soil is always open and receptive. The soil of our heart is always open and receptive to receiving the word, which is Christ. And what happens is that then our roots go very, very deep, and it's being watered deeply on a regular basis. In fact, it points out, when the roots of virtue and faith are watered by prayer and grace each day. And that goes back to the four steps to holiness that I always talk with people about: daily prayer and meditation, and frequent in living that life of grace by frequenting the sacraments to avail ourselves of all the grace that is present to us within the sacraments and within the sacramental life of the church. So when we are doing that, and then the third, of course, is to strive to grow in virtue, and the fourth, to abandon ourselves to God's will. All of those integrated into our life throughout each and every day will help our roots go deep in our interior life, in our soul, so that when we run into suffering, when we run into those temptations, we're able to withstand them. And this is sometimes what happens, is that sometimes we haven't been attentive to the roots of our soul. We've gotten lackadaisical, perhaps, on our daily prayer. It might be that we're just kind of doing it in a perfunctory way. We're not really allowing the word to take deep root in our heart and to reside there. Even if we don't feel that our prayer is bringing us any kind of satisfaction, consolations, and doesn't seem to be helping us make any progress, the fact is that Isaiah tells us the word never goes forth and does not return without bearing fruit. We have to trust, fourth step, we have to trust that God is working in our minds, in our hearts, and our souls, even when we don't see it. And this is the same thing about roots, is that we don't see them. We don't see whether or not a young plant has deep roots and whether or not they're shallow. All we can do is be attentive to the plant. So like we just put in sod, a brand new lawn, partially because we had attempted to overseed. And what happened was, is that we did that and then a big rain came and washed it all away. So the seed didn't even have a chance to try and grow roots before the next day we had a torrential rainstorm and literally it ran, you know, it washed it all away. We waited a couple weeks to see whether or not anything had taken root. And there were a couple here and there, but it definitely wasn't the entire lawn. So we said, okay, well, we're going to give it a best shot and we're going to go ahead and put inside. But what is it that we have to do for the next 2 weeks? We have to water it frequently and every day. So in fact, they say that you should water 3 to 5 times a day, you know, for 20 to 30 minutes for new grass. So it's something of where it goes to all of what, you know, we're speaking of today, is that we need to be attentive each and every day to water the roots of our soul. We do this by striving through grace and by living that life of grace, by going to the sacraments, by striving to live in virtue. And then when we trust God, and we do this by consecrating ourselves to Mary, we trust God's way for us. He gave us his mother to help us on this journey so that she can ensure that our soul is open and ready to receive the word, her son, each and every day, so that it can bear great fruit. And with Mary, as St. Louis de Montfort tells us, when Mary has struck her roots in a soul, she produces the marvels of grace, which is much, much fruit. And this, of course, will make our Heavenly Father rejoice. So let us go ahead and begin with the creed and then with our decade today. So I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. And let's remember our goal, to have Mary set deep roots in our soul. So, if anybody